Would you like to easily navigate your law firm's financial information? Well, in that case, you should prepare the required attorney-related reports. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Reports are the results of all the work we do in QuickBooks Online. There are some financial reports that a law firm must have in order to run properly. And the most important thing to remember is that reports are the best and quickest way to find anything you are looking for in QuickBooks Online. Now, there are only about 10 reports that we will need to use to see the whole financial picture of our law firm at any given moment. These reports are mixed in with all the other many reports that QuickBooks Online provides. So we will still save time by setting them aside. We will now learn how to customize the reports as we set them up. After we record transactions, the results get summarized in different ways and displayed on a variety of QuickBooks reports. After opening any report, you can customize the report to show the results of only the specific transactions that you may need. We will open, customize, and save all the important law firm necessary reports in one place. Then the rest of the course will be easy and smooth because we will be able to find anything we are looking for in an instant. So here are the common attorney required reports. And before I define them one by one, I'm going to show you where to click to open them up. Only in the left panel do you have the ability to click reports. And if you click reports from the left panel, there are three tabs across the top: standard reports, custom reports, and management reports. Now, the standard reports are all the reports that QuickBooks Online makes available to any type of company, and they're broken down into categories. We will not need all of them. We will pull out only the ones that will be specifically necessary for a law firm, and we will place them here in the custom reports section. This way we can access them very easily. So the first report that we're going to customize and save is called the trial balance. And that's the accumulated total results of every account in the chart of accounts. You can see the detail of transactions in any particular account just by clicking on it from the trial balance. The numbers in the trial balance are the same numbers that appear on all the other company financial statements, like the profit and loss and the balance sheet. So let's go ahead and customize the trial balance. We click reports and we pull it from the standard section. And for the trial balance, we have to scroll down very far because that's in the category of reports that relate to your accountant. And somewhere towards the bottom is here, trial balance. Now double click to open it up. And you may notice by default, automatically, it opens up between two specific dates. And that's the way the programmers wanted it. And you can see it has no data because we have not recorded any transactions yet. The proper way to save this is to click the pull down arrow and choose the top choice, all dates. Then after you make a change, when you customize a report, you can then click run report and it will adjust for that change. Of course, there's still no data because we did not enter any transactions. But if we click Save Customization, we could give it a slightly different name, but I will not. And you click Save. Now let's take a look to see if it saved it in the right place. When we click Reports and we click Custom Reports, our good friend the trial balance is here. And we double click and open it up, and we can see that it remembers that we want to see the results of all transactions regardless of date. Now we all know this report, the profit and loss. It shows the totals of the income category, expense category, and the net income of the entire law firm. You can customize the date to compare how well you did between two time periods. So let's go ahead and save that one. We click Reports, click the standard where we are pulling them from, and under the Business Overview category, just go down to Profit and Loss. Not Profit and Loss Detail, just plain old Profit and Loss. Click once, and you notice by default it opens year to date. We will click this, and we will choose All Dates, and click Run Report. Now, of course, it adjusted the words, but there are no transactions yet. Click Save Customization. You could change the name if you wanted to, but we will just click Save. Now when we click Reports, Custom, we can go directly to both of these without having to sift through tons and tons of irrelevant reports. Now, Profit and Loss by Customer shows the totals of the income category, expense category, and net income for each job or engagement you have with a client. It will tell you how much you made on each client engagement as well as each client overall. So it can summarize everything for the client or go job by job if you need to. You can compare how well you did from client to client or job to job by using this report. Same thing, standard, scroll down at the bottom of business overview, profit and loss by customer. Double click. Now, we don't want year to date, we want all. Then we run the report so that we know it will show the results of all transactions regardless of date. And then we click Save Customization, leave the name, you could always change it if you do something special to a report. Click Save, and now the one that says All Dates is in the Custom area. Reports, Custom, you see Profit and Loss by Customer, double click. It remembered the change that we made. And if you made any other change to customize this report and then ran it, you could save the customization, give it a name, and it will put that report in the custom area the way that you saved it. What about this transaction list by customer? Simply a list of every customer transaction, but it enables you to see all the activity between you and a client in date order. It does not show any balances. It is simply a list. So let's go ahead and pull it out. Reports, standard, come down, who owes you. Okay, it's not under who owes you, it's under sales and customers. Transaction list by customer. Click, not month to date, we want the results of all. We click run to get the results to change the way we customized it. Save customization. Let's leave their name for now. Click save. And believe me, it's on the list. What's next? The open invoice report shows every unpaid invoice by client. This is interesting. It shows the amount currently unpaid. Any advance payments not yet applied to clients' invoices will also show on this report. So we click reports, standard, we go down to the section of who owes you, and you click open invoices, and we click the pull down arrow, click all dates, run report to make it all dates, save customization, and the name suits us, So we click save, and believe me, it will remember the change. Now, the unbilled time and unbilled charges reports are two reports that both show expenses we paid for or were billed for that have not yet billed, that we have not yet billed the client for. The transactions will appear on this report if they were marked as billable when they were recorded. They will disappear from this report at the moment you place them on a client's invoice. So those are the next two reports. Standard, careful, go down after who owes you, sales and customers, what you owe, okay, expenses and vendors, okay, I think it's up here, unbilled time and unbilled expenses. Here, they're both here, unbilled charges and unbilled time. Click unbilled charges, it already says all dates. Save customization, save, then reports, go down to unbilled time, click here, it already says all dates, save customization, and save. Now, you can check to see that they're all being saved in the custom report area, and we're almost done. Try pausing the video and adding these three yourself. Then double check that they are in the custom area, and congratulations, you're almost done with the setup of a law firm in QuickBooks Online.